Greetings and salutations, YouTube family and friends. T-Rav Vlogs here. What's up, guys? So with Anime Senpai coming up this weekend, I figured I'd give you guys a bit of an update to some of my cosplay projects and whatnot, so you'll see what I'm going to be doing this weekend, so you can maybe look out for me and say hello. The first thing I want to address is my Joker wig. Now, a while back, I made a video kind of documenting the journey of styling the wig, putting it together and whatnot, and that video received quite a bit of hate, actually. To date, that video is my most disliked video of all the ones that I've posted. What does that mean exactly? Well, I don't really know, because all of the dislikes don't come with any constructive criticism or whatnot. I know the job was a little shoddy. It was my first attempt at doing anything like that as far as styling a wig, so it wasn't 100% accurate to the manga or the anime. However, I have seen quite a few Joker cosplays online, and some of them don't even try to style the hair. Maybe they knew something I didn't, but I thought that I at least attempted it. So, since that video, I have gone back and I have touched up the wig quite a few more times. I had it to a point where I was comfortable with it to take it to Anime Central, so you have seen the updated Joker wig in the Anime Central video, and you've also seen it in one of the Black Butler Cosplay St. Louis outings that we've done. So it's nothing new, but I did want to show you a closer look at the updated wig, so maybe the people who disliked the video will watch this one and maybe hopefully change their minds, or at least give me some constructive criticism as to what I did wrong, if there's a way I can fix it, or just why you didn't like the video in general. Right, so here is the updated wig. As you can see, I've kind of toned down the spikes quite a bit. They're a little more subtle. There are more of them because I did it a little smaller, and I kind of tried to keep the same look as before, but not quite as in your face. Blah, giant spikes. His hair isn't that in your face. It's just kind of more subtle. I think when I did it the first time, I concentrated too much on there being some giant spikes where there should have just been more medium to smaller size spikes and a lot more of them. I since put some hairspray on the little pink dangly guys here so they didn't get quite as frizzy. I fixed the bangs a little bit more so they're not going everywhere. Again, couldn't sweep this all the way back. That's just something I cannot do with this wig. So I just kind of tuck it behind the ear, but for the most part it works. These particular spikes back here don't tend to come out as far as I need them to, but that's okay really. These do a really good job. What I might do is the night before, I'll probably take him with me and I might push these guys out just a little more to make them pop just a smidge bit more. But for the most part, this is what I'm working with. I think it's 100% better. It's not the exact way the hair is in the anime. However, for what it's worth, I think it's one of the better Joker wigs out there. When I was at Anime Central, there were three of us. Myself, a young lady who pretty much took a picture of the hair and made it materialize. I don't know how she did it, but it was amazing. It looked almost too artificial, but it's anime. It's kind of supposed to. And then the other gentleman that was there, I think we had the same wig, but his styling choice was a little different. So, I mean, it's gonna differ from Joker to Joker, but I've noticed that if you watch the anime from frame to frame, his hair doesn't even remain the same. So how exactly do you style something where it changes from frame to frame? You can't really do that. So this is what you're working with. So this is what I've got. Hopefully all the haters out there think it's a lot better. I think it's a lot better. I think it'll work out really well. But enough talk about Joker. I do have one more costume that I'm doing for Anime Senpai this weekend, and that's Ronald Knox. Now with Ronald, again, you saw the majority of the costume in the Reaper's Outing video that I did. And in fact, near the end, Ronald even kind of showed you some of the new accessories that he had purchased that day. However, there were some accessories that you did not get to see in the video because I had not yet acquired them. First off, everybody knows that Ronald likes to step outside the norm as far as the Reaper uniform goes. Not quite as much as Grell, but he does like to add a few accents here and there that make him his own. First off being a white belt. Now the other Reapers, they usually keep the darker colors of the belts, the browns, the blacks, usually black because it's a black suit so it matches very well, but Ronald likes to stand out, so he keeps a white belt. I got this guy off of Etsy, relatively cheap price, so it should work out nicely, I think. Next, we have a detail that not a lot of cosplayers pay much attention to unless they're sticklers for detail, like myself. And unless Ronald has his jacket off, you don't even know he has them. But they are sleeve garters. Now he wears these on his sleeve here in his dress shirt because back in the Victorian era, they didn't have a lot of shirts or garments that fit the body perfectly, or at least in a way that worked for them. So sometimes you had to get a shirt that fit you in the chest and length, but the arms were way too long or something like that. And in order to fix that, you used a sleeve garter here. You put it up on your shoulder here, and you could draw your sleeves back, and the garter would hold the sleeves. And if you needed to roll up your sleeves all the way, that was a good way to do it as well. You didn't have to roll the fabric and then unroll it. You could just use the sleeve garter. Again, not really a detail that gets looked at very often, but because I am a stickler for detail, I like to include it. And finally, the pièce de résistance for Ronald Knox. And I had quite a difficult time trying to find these out of season, but white Oxford-style shoes. What do you think? Pretty nice, huh? Now, I know the lighting kind of makes them look a little wonky, but trust me, they are nice and bright white. They've got the black underpart here, and for being difficult to find, these things work out very well. Again, I've already tested them out. I used them with White Rabbit at the Botanical Gardens, and I had to look in a place called Royal Menswear up in the St. Clair Mall, and let me tell you, Amir and Assad, they took care of me. If you're in that area and you need some formal wear and you're a dude, they will hook you up. Trust me, these guys took good care of me and I was so happy to have these shoes because, let's face it, again, Ronald Knox does not follow the norm as far as Reapers go, so he is constantly looking for ways to kind of stick it to the system a little bit and make his appearance pop just that much more. So not a whole lot to show you here right before Anime Senpai, but I wanted to give you guys some last minute details so that you could maybe pick me out a little bit. Oh, hey, that's T-Ravlogs over there. I should go say hi. And of course, I'll have some of the cards and whatnot for the Black Butler Cosplay St. Louis group if you guys aren't already a part of that. And also the link to the YouTube channel, again, if you guys aren't already subscribed, which I hope you guys, if by now you are seeing this, you should be subscribed. So that's gonna be it for this little update, just a quick one. I cannot wait to see you guys at Anime Senpai. Like I said, come by and say hello. I love meeting people. I love hearing that people watch the videos. I love hearing that people are fans of Black Butler or anime in general. And Anime Senpai is gonna be a 3-day con this year. It's changed from Anime Getaway, so I cannot wait to see what this convention holds. It's gonna be a great time. So that's really all I've got to say about that. So until next time, I'll talk to you guys soon, and take care. Bye-bye.